perubahan di dunia teknologi, perubahan di dunia budaya, ini akan semakin cepat, semakin rumit, dan semakin tidak bisa dipredik.
Sangat banyak kesempatan dan tantangan yang perlu dijawab, tak cukup sekedar berontak dan bergerak tanpa sebab. Kita adalah sepucuk surat bagi masa depan. Kaki langit adalah kapal batas untuk ditaklukkan.
A life-changing history. Right, a solid mission of the visionaries. It was Dr. Anka and his colleagues' mission to accelerate technology development through the establishment of Institute Technology 10 November. Their goodwill has encouraged ITS students to take important roles in both local and global communities. Ministers, CEOs, professors, entrepreneurs, and yes, another history maker. These successful alumni were trained in a healthy learning environment that was equipped with various supporting facilities. Vocation to marine technology. All faculties and departments of ITS were formed to be the best place to learn science, technology, and design. Seven faculties and one interdisciplinary school. Scientics, Faculty of Science and Data Analytics. MarTech, Faculty of Marine Technology. Faculty of Industrial Technology and Systems Engineering. Electics, Faculty of Intelligent Electrical and Informatics Technology. CivPlan, Faculty of Civil, Planning and Geoengineering. CreateBiz, Faculty of Creative Design and Digital Business. Vocation, Faculty of Vocation, and Interdisciplinary School of Management and Technology. Recognized as one of the top best-ranked institutes doesn't mean the finish line for ITS. To gain greater international recognition, ITS launched International Undergraduate Program. Students can get wider international exposure through 20 study programs they can apply. the chances are also open for professors from all over the world to teach and conduct research at ITS. These opportunities have made international joint research and other international activities successfully performed. Like IUP, students and lecturers from other programs have also contributed to the ITS achievements. Appreciations earned exemplify Institute's excellent performance. But technology and academic excellence is not the only goal of the Institute. Students are guided to apply their knowledge for the welfare of society. To note a new life-changing history, technology must advance humanity. ITS, Institute Technology, 10 November.
Remember when I told you no matter where I go, I'll never leave your side, you will never be alone. Even when we go through changes, even when we're wrong, remember that I told you I'll find my way back home. I could never let you go, couldn't run away if I tried. Even when I'm all alone, you got a hold of my mind. And I'll always let you know that I'm always gonna hold on. And I told you right from the start, you just say the word and I go. No, it doesn't matter how far, cause your love is all that I know. Baby, you just stay where you are, and you know I won't be too long. Hold on, hold on. Remember when I told you no matter where I go, I'll never leave your side, you will never be alone. Even when we go through changes, even when we're wrong, remember that I told you I'll find my way back home.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, before we start commence the program, and here are the following webinar protocol. For each participant ID, please use your real name following with your origin of institution. All of participants are expected to mute the audio and only unmute the video during the event. We cordially invite you to take your own firm and comfort seat in your own room, and please avoid the backlight. Make sure that you have a good and stable internet connection. If you have an earphone or headset, we recommend you to use it so that your voice can clearly and loudly to be heard. During the Q&A discussion session, all participants, please use the chat box to deliver the questions. Thank you for your cooperation and consideration.
Ali, still mute, Ali, ya?
Can you hear my voice?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So, hello again. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Let's Study Abroad February edition that is held today, 23rd of February 2022. On this beautiful day, I am very glad to see all of you here participating in our event with high curiosity. First of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Alga, as your Master of Ceremony for today. Alright, before we enter the main session, I would like to remind all of the participants to fill out the attendance form that is shared by our committee in the chat box. And please remember that you will not be able to fill it out once the form is closed in the next 30 minutes. While we are waiting for the participants to fill out the attendance form, I will explain briefly what LSA is. So LSA, or Let's Study Abroad, is a discussion and consultation session by ITS University partners from all around the world for all student levels. Today, we have representatives from our three partner universities. The first one is Mr. Syed Raihan and Mr. Nazmul Islami from Daffodil International University, Bangladesh. The second one is Ms. Lucy Grasset and Ms. Marine from EPITA France. And the last one is Ms. Mia Hernawati from Kumamoto University in Japan. Now, today's agenda will be started with an opening speech from the division coordinator, then continue with an opening speech from ITS Global Engagement Management, and then its partner university will share about their institution and their programs. After that, we will have a panel discussion session where you will be able to ask about the general question that will be answered by its university's representatives. After that, you will enter the breakout rooms, and there will be one room for its partner university. In this breakout room, you may inquire more detailed questions and consult with the representatives from its university. All right, now I will proceed to our first agenda, which is an opening speech from the committee representative, Evita Emanuela Nauli. Without further ado, to Evita, the time is yours.
All right. Thank you, Alia, for the brief introduction. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you to each and every one of you for being here with us today. I hope all of you are always in good condition. I want to say welcome and thank you to the three of the university partner that contributes today to share and introduce about your wonderful university program for international students. And to the Honorable, the Management and Staff of ITS Global Engagement, Mas Wahyu Islami Pratama ST as the Manager for Contact and Mobility Program, Medisi Kurniawati SS as the Staff for International Student Admission, and other Management and Staff of ITS Global Engagement. And also Mbak Angie Putri Octavia and Mbak Sekar Puspitasari as the Coordinator of Internalization and Development Volunteer Division, my fellow volunteer friends and all the participants in this Zoom. Let me introduce myself. My name is Evita Emanuel Nauli as the committee representative for LSE February edition 2022. As our Master of Ceremony said today, LSA, or Let's Study Abroad, is a discussion and consultation session by ITS University partners from all around the world for all student levels. In my opinion, going to study abroad is not only about your grade, country, or English skill, but also knowing well the program that the university offers, scholarship, and other information about the university. And here today, we have very, very awesome university partners. There are Daffodil International University Bangladesh, EPITA France, and Kumamoto University Japan. We hope all the participants here do not waste this opportunity. Don't miss any single information. Ask as many as you can, because we never know, you guys already one step closer to achieve your study abroad dream. That's all from me. I wish everyone the best of luck. Enjoy the session. Thank you. Back to you, Alia.
Thank you very much, Evita, for the beautiful opening speech. We hope today's LSA can encourage us to participate in future programs held by our partner universities. The next agenda is an opening speech from ITS Global Engagement Management that will be delivered by Ms. Desi Kurniawati, Sarjana Sastra, or usually called as Ms. Desi. For your information, Ms. Desi is one of the International Student Admission and Mobility Staff in ITS Global Engagement. Without any further ado to Ms. Desi, the time is yours.
Okay, thank you very much, Alia, for your kind introduction. Okay, good evening all. First of all, on behalf of ITS Global Engagement Management, we would like to express our special thanks to the representative of Daffodil International University of Bangladesh, EPITA School of Engineering and School and Computer Science friends, and also Kumamoto University Japan for your willingness to join our special event named LSA. ITS and the three universities that attend this event has established very good relationships and collaboration in student action and also lecture mobility. This semester, we have students from Daffodil International University who join our online student exchange, and students from EPITA who join our offline student exchange here. We hope that this collaboration have a rolling. We are happy to have your student here. And also we hope that we can send our ITS student to join your program. For ITS students who join this session, you may get many information about the study abroad from the world's leading university. And also you may ask in detail about the program to the representative of the universities. Okay, I think that's all from me. Thank you very much and enjoy the sessions.
All right, thank you very much, Ms. Desi, for the insightful opening speech. Moving right along, the next agenda is a presentation by Mr. Syed Raihan and Mr. Nazmul Islami from Daffodil International University, Bangladesh. To Mr. Syed Raihan and Mr. Nazmul Islami, I will pass the virtual microphone to you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, the MC, Ms. Alia, Madam Desi, as well as Evita, for your very nice introduction. And I'm very happy to be part of this today's program. And of course, Mr. Wahyu, for inviting the international team of Daffodil International University for today's program. And a very good day to all the participants from ITS Surabaya who are joining us today. And is Silamat Datang. And okay, so I will be presenting a slide of our university as well as about Bangladesh, and my colleague Mr. Nazmul will be also presenting two different videos. One is actually based on Bangladesh and another will be based on our summer school program that we host every year on our campus. So first I will be giving my presentation. So if you have any kind of questions, you can of course write in the chat box, or you can write during the session, or even in the breakout.
Okay, Mr. Syed, Mr. Nasmul, and also Miss Lucy, before that, I would like to introduce, welcome the Dean of Faculty of Electrical Engineering, Intelligent Antigen, Professor Ketut Edi. Thank you so much, Bapak, for coming. And also some of EPS staff also join, Mr. Syed, Mr. Nasmul, and also Miss Lucy. So thank you so much, Bapak. Thank you. Okay, please you may continue your presentation. So sorry, just to introduce.
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah, thank you. And welcome everyone. And of course, I'm also very happy that yesterday one of our graduates, he finished our graduation in our university and received the KNB scholarship from the Indonesian government and just landed to ITS yesterday. I see the photo of your staff and students also welcome him. And I hope that his stay in ITS will be very great. And I myself visited the university, and I believe the stay will be nice, and he will be having new taste of life in ITS, and of course having nasi goreng in the lunch, in the dinner, and every time. Yeah. So let me move on to my slides. Okay, just let me know if you can see my slide actually. If it is okay, can you see it?
Yes,
you can see.
Okay, I just did the full screen. Okay, so welcome to Daffodil International University. I myself, Mr. Syed Rahimul Islam, the Senior Associate Director of International Affairs Office, and my team are working for the internationalization of the university. And this is Daffodil International University. We are situated in Bangladesh, of course, a very neighboring country of Indonesia. And we are in Asia, and the motto of the university is a landmark to create the future. Okay, so as you can see that in the world map, Bangladesh is not very far. Of course, we are close to India. And from here, Indonesia flight, if we say about flight time, it is about like 6 hours, around almost 6 hours or 30 minutes if we go via Malaysia. So Bangladesh is a neighboring country, and there are many more similarities with Indonesia and Bangladesh. And let me share with you some more details. Okay. Bangladesh is based on, of course, in South Asia. Bangladesh is a mostly densely populated country. In South Asia, we have 162 million people with a small land. It's like 148,000 plus square kilometers. And the majority of the people in Bangladesh is actually Muslim. Like around 90% is actually Muslim. Around 9.6% is actually Hindu, and others religions are Buddhist and Christians in the country. And the mother tongue that we speak in our country is actually Bangla. So about 98% people are actually speaking the language Bangla, which is our mother language. And also there are about 27 minority groups who actually the other 1.1% of the population. And I would like to also show you the beautiful picture of the largest and the longest sea beach in the world, which is actually in Bangladesh. And it's actually the widest one. You can say 120 kilometers long sea beach without any break. So it is the longest sea beach in the world. And there is a proverb that the time measurement to travel from one part to other part of this Cox's Bazar sea beach is like you need 3 days to walk from one part to other part of the sea beach. So you see that it is quite large. And when you actually travel to our country, you will be exploring this beautiful sea beach of Cox's Bazar. And we have the largest mango forest of the world in Bangladesh, which is named Sundarban. So 60% of this mango forest are actually in Bangladesh, and 40% is actually in India. And this Sundarban is also called the UNESCO World Heritage Site in Bangladesh, beside the Cox's Bazar, the longest sea beach in the world. And when you will be coming during the winter season, there are also different trips in this largest mangrove forest via launch and other steamers and others. So you can actually explore Bangladesh through different ways. And Bangladesh is a land of different diversity, culture, and heritage. There are a lot of similarities, of course, with Indonesia. And you see some of the photographs that I am showing here, the Lalbagh Fort, which is actually in city, the Hatijin Lake, it is the night view in the city, the National Memorial, and also the National Parliament of the country. And also Bangladesh, when you fly over the country, you will be seeing there are a lot of rivers in our country. So the Bangladesh is a land of rivers, and you can actually travel via small and medium as well as larger boats within the country from one district to others. And we have a tea garden in the hill tracks area, which is also a very nice place to explore. There is also different lakes in different parts of the country. There are many tourist places where you can actually explore when you are traveling to Bangladesh as an exchange student or full-time or any other short-term or long-term period. So these are some of the daily life, the heritage, and some beautiful places of the country. So I just shared with some for the photo so that you have some idea of our country. And also you see that there is a photograph of a tricycle. So in the city, in the capital, you will see a lot of tricycle as well as the whole country. And this is quite interesting to travel with the tricycle, of course. And the information I was also thinking to share with you is kind of fun, of course. Like in Indonesia, we call nasi goreng ayam, the food that I also myself tried when I was visiting ITS Surabaya, and which is very common and very famous there. There are also other food, of course, but similar to that, in Bangladesh, the people also like rice with chicken and mutton and as well as beef. So these are the food you can actually try with interest. There is chicken biryani, which is similar to nasi goreng ayam in Indonesia, as well as the famous one, of course, for Dhaka. The capital is kachi biryani. So when you will be coming to Bangladesh, don't miss to try this food. Let us more focus on the University of, I mean, Daffodil International University, as I said about Bangladesh, now I'm moving to the university. So Daffodil International University is part of Daffodil family. Daffodil family is a group of companies, as you see, the stairs of different companies that were established, started back in 1990, the Daffodil family. So we have school, college, university, we have IT institutes, we have our own branded computer and many other features. So all are connected with education, IT and business. So when you will be coming to our university, not only the education, you can also, of course, different industrial area as well as like internships, and there are many more possibilities to explore the organizations that are actually under the Daffodil family. And Daffodil family, if I talk about the fact and figures of Daffodil family, so we have more than 650 foreign institutions as a partner with our different school, college, university, IT institutes, and many things. And also we have more than 2,000 alumni who are represented in different organizations as a leader, as well as we have more than 50K actually into together, 50,000 alumni in different parts of the world are actually attending in different sections. And if I talk about the university, you see this is the green campus, the beautiful green campus of Daffodil International University, which is very near to the city, just about 30 minutes drive from the capital. And our university was established in the year 2002. And it's a young university, of course. And within this short time, we have now around 23,000 plus students from all around the country. And of course, we have also international students from many different parts of the world. We have more than 400 international students. And earlier, we had also many students from Indonesia who come to our university to study their full-time undergraduate master's program. And every year we also organize different programs that I'll be talking about, which is based on the summer school, winter school, as well as like student exchange, internships, and other different scholarship programs. And to run the university very successfully, we have a very strong team of faculty and admin staffs, which is more than 1,200 plus. And these are actually the top management of the university. In the middle, you can see the Honorable President of the Bangladesh, People's Republic of Bangladesh. And by his power, he's actually the Chancellor of all the universities in Bangladesh, including Daffodil International University. And in left side, you can see Professor Dr. Abdul Rahman. He's actually the Vice Chancellor and the owner of the Daffodil family and Daffodil International University, Dr. M. Visobukan, who is also the first Vice President of Association of Universities Asia and the Pacific. And ranking, or Daffodil International University is still a young university, but we are always ensuring quality education, internationalization, green campus, entrepreneurship, and many different areas. So this is how we are actually moving ahead. And in Bangladesh, we became the first among all the private universities to be the number one in times higher education. And in world ranking, we are within 301 to 400. In QS ranking in Asia, we became third among all the private universities in Bangladesh. And of course, since our university is a green campus, Bangladesh is of course a green country, and we are also very hospitable. We invite a lot of international delegations in our country to visit our university as well as in the country. So we also have the green campus movement. So with UI Green Matrix, we are also number one in the country. In the meantime, I actually forgot to show you a video about beautiful Bangladesh. So I'm just giving a pause for now, and I will be showing you a 3 minute short video. My colleague, Mr. Najmul, will be showing a short video on beautiful Bangladesh, and then I will be continuing the rest of the details of our university. So I'm requesting my colleague, Mr. Najmul, to show the video on beautiful Bangladesh.
যত দেখি প্রাণ ভরে না হৃদয়ের মাঝে রাখি তারে
Happiness needs no reason. This is what you will feel when you come here. Things that you will do, people that you will meet, will keep on surprising you. Sun. Be with the mystic wind.
Jotoi dekhi pran bhore na tai hridoy majhare rakhi tare যতই দেখি প্রাণ ভরে না তাই হৃদয় মাঝারে রাখি তাহারে
Your mind is a traveler. Now let your heart be the tourist guide. Surprises. You'll find warmth you've been looking for all your life. Here, everyone has a story to tell. So, when you leave, You leave with stories that you can treasure, friends that will last a lifetime.
Jotoi dekhi pran bhore na tai hridoy machare rakhi tare যতই দেখি প্রাণ ভরে না তাই হৃদয় মাঝারে রাখি
Welcome to beautiful Bangladesh, a land of stories.
Thank you, Mr. Najmul, and I hope all the participants, the students, those who are attending today has enjoyed the beautiful Bangladesh, the video that we have shown. And let us move ahead with more about Daffodil International University in Bangladesh. So our university is actually two different semester systems. So most of the programs that we are running in our university, the undergraduate program as well as the master's program, are based on trimester system. So the semesters, the spring semester, the first semester of the year, that start in the January and end in April. And the summer semester is actually in May and end in August, and the fall semester is starting in September and ends in December. So between each semester, we have actually 15 days break for the trimester system. And when we have the courses like pharmacy and engineering courses, the courses are actually based on bi-semester system. So it's actually from January to May and January to June, and from July to December. And we have actually five different faculties in our university. So all the courses and programs are divided into five different faculties. So Faculty of Business and Entrepreneurship, Faculty of Science and Information Technology, Faculty of Engineering, Faculty of Allied Science, and last but not the least, the Faculty of Humanities and Social Science. So under these five faculties, we have different departments, different majors. So like Business Administration, Business Studies, Real Estate, Tourism, and Innovation and Entrepreneurship. So these are the departments that are under the Faculty of Business and Entrepreneurship. And in the engineering, we have the Civil Engineering, Electrical Engineering, Textile, Architecture, Civil Engineering, and others. And of course, the vibrant department that we have in our university, which is the largest one, is actually the Computer Science and Engineering department. So we have more than 8,000 students in total in this department. And there are other departments related to this computer science and engineering, like majoring in computers, software engineering, the computing and information system. We also have environmental science and disaster management, multimedia creative technology. And also we have the social science, where we have English, law, journalism, development studies. And also in the allied science, we have the public health department, where most of the students are actually the international students from many different countries. We have the Department of Pharmacy, Nutrition and Food Engineering as well. So when you come to our university, you can choose the department to study for one semester, depending on your major in your home university. And also our university is very much focused on research activities. So we have four different research centers, like under the faculties. Also, we have journals that are publishing every year from different faculties with the involvement of our local or our students from local and international background, also the professors from here and abroad as well. And our university is very much focused on internationalization. So we have many different international memberships, and with their empowerment, with the support, our students are also connecting in different universities all around the world. And of course, ITS and DIU is also became partner in this kind of memberships. And we have more than 440 international partner universities from many different countries, Asia, Europe, Africa, North America, and many other different regions. And with them, we are regularly doing different kind of exchange programs and others. And I would like to show you some of the photographs of our university campus. So our university is a green campus, of course. You can see the gate here, the campus gate. This is the central mosque, and also the cafeteria for the students, teachers to have their daily meals. This is the innovation lab, where we nurture our students of innovation and entrepreneurship, as well as other students, those who are coming up with different ideas to innovate new technologies on different business ideas. So they do their business practices and innovation practices with this lab. We have the largest independent open hall for the mega events like concert, like foundation day, like competition ceremony and others. And this is the picture where there are about 6,000 plus students became graduate in previous years. So this is the convocation ceremony program. These are some of the photographs of the beautiful green campus of our university. And also these are the digital mega classrooms. We have the multimedia lab rooms and others, of course, within the university campus to facilitate our students with the digital amenities. We have the one of the largest libraries among all the universities in Bangladesh. And this library was inaugurated last year with all kinds of technological facility, and about more than 1,000 students can study in this library at a time. We have a lot of e-resources, reference books, journals, project reports, where when you become our part of our university as a exchange student or other different areas, of course, you can explore these opportunities. And all the departments, all the programs are also featured with practical education. So we have different laboratories, we have different labs in pharmacy, in multimedia, in marketing, as well as other different features. And of course, our university is very much focused on the sports facilities for the students on campus. So these are some of the photographs that the students are always active on campus, and they're playing different outdoor and indoor games. And also they're participating not only national level, as well as the international level to contribute to the national sports amenities. And these are some of the more photographs that the Green Campus Movement, as I said, and you can see some students in the last photo in the right side, they all are from the Indonesian partner universities that they came before in our different programs. I think these students are actually from Erlangga University, I guess, it is also from Surabaya. And these are some photographs from our Green Campus. And our university, as I said, we are also Green Campus Movement-based university. We have carbon management plan, biogas plan, tree plantation, greenhouse, gas reduction, and forestation. These are initiatives that are enabled in this Green Campus Movement initiatives. And to encourage and to facilitate the international students to live on campus and facilitate them in our university, so we have the student dormitory and housing. And of course, this is the building which is actually focusing on the international students to live. And this dormitory is fully occupied with all kinds of digital and security and all kinds of facilities that a dormitory or the housing should have. So we have different facilities that we are giving to our students with all kinds of Wi-Fi, internet, study room, 24 hours canteen facility, laundry, prayer room, shuttle bus service with the city, CCTV camera, and all kinds of facilities for the dormitory. And these are some of the photographs of the dormitory inside, like living, I mean, the sports, the canteen, and others for the students. This is also, I wanted to include that every year we also invite different faculty members from many different countries to teach our students in different programs. So these are the international guest houses where faculty members are living on campus. And our university, we have also quite a big transport pool where we have around 70 buses to travel from many different corners of the city. And they are bringing the students, there are shuttle bus services, they're coming from the city as well. And these are some of the photographs of the club activities where our students are also engaged. And when you become a part of our university, you can of course take part in this kind of activities with our students. There are many virtual platforms that are being used inside the university, like campus TV, campus radio, vlog, and forum, where you can be connected with your teachers, students, and others. And we are actually the number one university in Bangladesh considering the innovation and entrepreneurship movement, because we have the Department of Entrepreneurship, which is the only department in the country considering the private university in Bangladesh. And we nurture the new entrepreneurs to be empowered. So we have the Daffodil Business Incubator and also the Startup Market Initiative where the students we nurture. We also give the co-funding to these business initiatives. There are many visiting professors that are coming to our university every year to teach our students from Asia, Europe, and different parts of the world. And yes, this is the high time to show you about the summer school program that we organize every year in our beautiful campus. So we have the International Social Business Summer Program that we are organizing since 2017. And last 2 years, due to COVID-19, we organized the summer school program online. But when you organize it on campus, what are the features that we give our students? So this program is focusing on social business movement. So when the students are coming from all around the world, they are learning about the social business concept that was invented by the Nobel laureate, Professor Muhammad Yunus. And this summer school program is 3 academic credit based summer school program for 10 days. So students, they go to the community, they learn about the social business, they go to the industries, they meet the expert and Grameen Bank MDs, they meet the Nobel laureate Professor Muhammad Yunus, and they also get 3 academic credits. They have also different cross-cultural activities in the program. So my colleague will be also showing one video about the summer school program that we organized in this platform, like International Social Business Summer Program on campus. So I'd like to request my colleague, Mr. Najmul, to show again the summer school program so that the participants are having some idea.
That happened in this beautiful, beautiful country. This is a very, very great program, and I thought you all should also join this ISBSB program next year.
It was really awesome to share different cultures and different ideas.
This 10 days that I am actually out of India, I felt like I am in my country.
It has shown practically that we as people of this world can make a difference through business.
Thank you, Mr. Najmul, for sharing the video from our International Social Business Summer Program. Of course, you see the summer school program we hosted on campus, which is very much interesting to learn the social business techniques as well as to participate in cross-cultural activities. So if you want to know more about the summer school program, you can, of course, visit the website at the isbsp.daffodiluniversity.edu.bd. And besides the summer school program, we organized the summer school program last 2 years in online platform, where also students from ITS also took part. So this is one of the photographs. We have more than 130 participants from many different countries. And of course, we are hoping that this year we can organize it on campus. And beside when we have the program, we'll be circulating it. And of course, ITS will be welcoming the students to apply and come to the Daffodil University on campus. And there are other virtual programs we organize in the university. We also organize the winter camps and leadership programs where the students from different countries, as a university, they send like about 10, 20, 15, and 30 students to come and learn about the leadership, entrepreneurship, and about the Bangladeshi language and culture as well. And of course, if you want to be an exchange student, you can also you are also welcome to visit our university for 1 semester to 1 year period of time. And there is no need to pay any tuition fee. And every year we are exchanging around 600 and more students under the short-term and long-term student exchange program with our international partners from different countries. So if you would like to apply for this exchange program, you just need to meet your international office, Mr. Vayu, and also other team members. They will be guiding you. You can apply and you can send the documents to us. We'll be guiding you to the rest of the process. And if any query, you can, of course, reach me in my email address given in these slides. And the cost is also a matter to know about in Bangladesh. Bangladesh is almost similar to Indonesian economy in a sense, like the cost is not very higher. So monthly accommodation in our university dormitory or the hostel on campus is about $100 to $120. For the international students, it's a shared room. The monthly meal cost will be around $120 to $150. Depends on your lifestyle and how you want to spend your days and the food habits. The insurance depends how long you want to stay in Bangladesh. It can be 4 months or 6 months based on, and you can do it either in Bangladesh or maybe in Indonesia as well. And monthly local transport, we have our own transport system, or if you want to use your own or you want to travel, so roughly around $50 to $60, you can also keep as a save. And to know more about the different facilities in our university, of course, you are welcome to visit our university website. There are different programs in different faculties where we have also a lot of international students. And these are the cost structure you can see. So the cost structure is also not very higher in terms of the study in undergraduate program in our university. So I'm not going more in details. And also there are scholarship programs for international students to come and study in our university. So you can find all the details in our website if you also explore, and you can find different requirements. And also if you need to know more, you can also email us to know about how you can get the scholarships and the process in the university. And every year we also invite different university delegation to come to our university to have cross-cultural activities, sharing their culture. So these are some of the photographs that we had before from the students from Oxford University. They came to our university to perform the jazz music concert. We also had the student team from Korea to perform the K-pop music concert in our university. So these are some of the photographs. So I believe in future, the students from ITS will be also coming to our university to perform Indonesian culture. And last, I also would like to share one information that we have the postgraduate research summit that is going to be hosted from 27th February to March 1 for 3 days. So if you are interested, you can also explore this program about research activity or the PhD degree and how it's working. So you can learn about these techniques if you are a student from final year or even master's and others, you can also take part. So the registration deadline is 25th February. And also there are other details are here. I can also share you the link in the chat box, maybe a few minutes later. And every year we have a lot of HS programs that we are doing with our partner university, it's rising. So of course, ITS is a great partner for us to have participants from our university are joining, and the students and the teachers joining different programs in ITS, and of course ITS students are coming.
So Mr. Chia, maybe you may be quick because these are running up the time.
Yeah, so I'm finishing in 2 minutes, and of course you can visit our social media pages, website, and you can email us if you need any information to know. And thank you so much for listening to me. So be international and be with Daffodil International University. Thank you so much.
All right, thank you very much also for the excellent presentation, Mr. Sheikh Raihan and Mr. Nazmul Islami. It is well written and very informative. And I also agree that the Bangladesh is one of the beautiful country. But for the participants, if you have any questions, please keep your questions right now because we will have the second presentation from EPITA France that will be delivered by Miss Lucy Grasset and Miss Marian. To Miss Lucy Grasset and Miss Marian, I will pass the virtual microphone to you.
Hello, thank you so much. Thanks for this invitation to this event, the Let's Study Abroad. I will share my screen with you. Hope it will work right now. I hope you can see now the screen. Not yet.
Yes, already visible.
Already, perfect.
Okay, great. Okay, so let's start. Why would you share your choice EPITA? EPITA is located in France, in Europe. Is actually, France is centrally located in Europe. So when you come in France, you can access to all European countries really easily with a flight or train. And with your French visa, you can travel in the Schengen area, which is 26 European countries, and every European country is different. So when you come at EPITA, you have this opportunity to visit not only France, but Europe. But in France, there's also a lot to see. Our campus is located in Paris, which is here, but every French region has its own specialties in terms of culinary, cheese, wine, also activities. And so feel free when you come at EPITA to travel around France, and it's really easy to connect every part of the country for a weekend, because we have a great railway connection, a high-speed train to go from Paris to Bordeaux, to Marseille, Lille or Nantes, okay? Also, EPITA is a school of engineering, specialized in computer science, but we are part of a big group, UNIS Education Group, which is a leader of private higher education in France. It represents 25 schools, 80,000 alumni, and all represent 28,500 students. EPITA in itself, the school, as I said, is an engineering school in computers and IT. It's about 3,000 students in 5 different campuses. So we are a very small school. We have our one French language center and cybersecurity labs, but a lot also research labs at EPITA on artificial intelligence, cybersecurity, robotics, and a lot of others, research teams as well. EPITA, we have city campuses. That means that we're not outside the city, we are inside with all other buildings. So our campuses are located in Paris, the main ones, where you have English courses teach are based in Paris. We have other campuses in France, but you will have only the classes in French. So if you know French, you can go in those campuses. Otherwise, the best option is to go on our campuses located in Paris. So it's just in the south part of Paris, we have our campuses, and you can connect to the city center in 30 minutes by metro line. So when you are studying at EPITA, you can also enjoy the Parisian life in itself because you are in the city itself. Our campus is an intercultural campus. That means that we have more of 3,350 international students from all over the world. We are also glad to have 93 university partners, such as ITS, located in 45 countries. We're not only sending students abroad, like we have students currently at ITS for this semester, but we also welcome students here because we have all our programs, both in French and English. Also, we have a certification, Choose French certification, which has been awarded to EPITA. And it's based on 5 criteria. It means that we can have facilities to receive students from abroad, campus life and post-graduate support for the students. Now I would like to show you a video of our orientation week we organize for all our students every semester, for fall or spring semester. We organize a week so that students can know each other. So I will ask my colleagues from ITS to share their screen and show this video. Thank you.
The video, Miss Lucy.
Okay. Otherwise, don't worry. Okay. Otherwise, no worry. Because maybe we are running out of time. So, the link that will be shared with you after the session, if you prefer.
Yes. I can. Maybe you may continue first, and then I will play in the before you end your presentation.
Okay. Thank you. All right. Then let's focus on our exchange program. Our exchange program means that you can come at EPITA for a semester or 1 year without paying any fees. The first way is to contact your international office to know the process of internal application. Once you have been done this, you can I will receive the nomination from ITS, and then I will contact you and give you all the steps to apply and also prepare all the visa documents to arrive in France. Our partnership agreement with ITS is 10 students per academic year. So we hope to welcome you now because we are sending students to ITS. So we are looking forward to have you here at EPITA. And also there's another way to come at EPITA is for our summer school program. It's a 3-week program. And we offer different kind of courses to go in depth on your skills, improve your skills in computer science. And also we have a French language and culture program for this summer school. So when you come at EPITA, you can, because we have our French learning center, you can learn French during these 3 weeks and also travel in Paris and France to discover the French lifestyle. There's also a video on this summer program. I'm not sure if we have time to show it. Otherwise, as my colleague says, we can see it afterward.
Yes. We can. We have time to show.
Okay.
Just a moment. From your website, right?
Yes. Do you want me to send you the link again?
Yes. Please.
Okay. Sorry.
I didn't find it again. Okay. Sorry.
Oh, no, it's me. I'm sorry. I didn't send it to the appropriate person. So I'm sorry for this.
You can send to the chat box. So I will.
Yes. Did you see it?
Yes.
Okay.
Me process for a while.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Okay,
so you will see a video that has been done in 2019 before the sanitary crisis when we will be able to do it on site.
Okay, here we go. Wait a second.
Okay.
So
you.
I will share from my screen.
summer schools are organized to welcome international students for a period of 3 weeks in July. We have students from all over the world who come and participate in different programs. And this year, we were happy to have more than 109 students that participate in our cyber and IT program, our French language and culture program, our artificial intelligence. And they not only had expertise in a technical domain, but also they participated in company visits and discovered Paris in July.
So the summer school was amazing. I loved being an EPibody and I'm so happy to have showed the Korean students around Paris. And you need to do the summer school because it's one of the best experiences you can have in your entire life.
Hello, my name is Eugene. I only know Bonjour and Je m'appelle Eugene. And I only can speak on the phone like this, something like this.
Hey there, my name is Jay Delorier. I'm the professor of cybersecurity here at EPITA for the summer school. We've got a really great program that we're delivering over 3 weeks. So we do lots of content. We do a lot of introductory material, and then we get into penetration tests, common network attacks. We do a whole overview of cryptology and of network architecture, and it gives the students a really good base for building their kind of cybersecurity futures. We've got students from all over the world, so from overseas, and from here in Europe, and from even so far as Australia. So it's been a great couple weeks so far, and we're looking forward to the last week.
Daffodil이 너무 잘 챙겨줘서 고마웠어요.
진짜 밥 같은 것도 점심 시간마다 매일매일 다 갖다 주고 줄 기다릴 때도 막 힘들지 않게 즐겁게 해주고 필드 트립 나갈 때도 한 명 한 명 다 챙겨줘가지고 진짜 고마웠어요.
Thank you, Daffodil.
Thank you, Daffodil.
Estoy estudiando aquí en Francia el curso de Cyber and IT Security. Me está gustando muchísimo. Los maestros, las personas, todos son muy amigables. El contenido del curso está excelente. Estamos aprendiendo sobre un chorro de cosas de ciberseguridad. Me encanta París, es una ciudad muy bonita. Tiene mucha cultura, mucho arte. La comida está muy, muy rica. Me está gustando mucho EPITA. Una excelente universidad.
Thank you so much for sharing. We share my screen again. So we hope to organize also a non-site summer program this July. Can you see now my screen? I reshare my screen. Great, okay. So if you want to have more information on the summer program, there will be more information on our website, but also you can contact us as well. Also, to get updates on our exchange program, we have prepared a SWAY presentation online to leave you all the updated course list and syllabi, academic calendar, but also all the data and procedures. So if you're interested in this exchange program, you can also have updates, regular updates via this SWAY. our programs. So as I said, we have the whole program in English. So if you know any French, which can happen, of course, because French is a difficult language. So if you know only English, you can, of course, come for an exchange program at EPITA because the whole program will be in English. The first 2 years will be focused on a foundation on mathematics, physics, algorithmics. There will be also team project in programming. If you come for the third year, we have a fundamental semester. That means it's you will see technical skills such as programming language, but also engineering cycle in a and also management classes in this program. And then the fourth year, if you are currently in the fourth year, you can come and join us for different specialization in computer science. We have one program on data science and analytics, computer security, software engineering, and innovative information system management. On this program, you will focus on technical skills, mainly in this specific domain. Also, when you will be, when you come for an exchange semester, you will be able to learn French because we have our one French language center at EPITA. This is the fifth most spoken language. So it's a good opportunity when you come for an exchange semester to know some of the French words like coup de foudre, excellent, oh la la. I don't know if you know them, but when you will be at EPITA, you will have French classes integrated in the program. Also, at EPITA, we have a different kind of credit system. This is just a slight presentation of the ECTS, European Credit Transfer System, is a credit system for all Europe. Basically, is the equivalence is one local credit, I mean, one US credit equal to two ECTS. And students must obtain at least 10 out of 20 to get the credits. When you will be admitted at EPITA, then we will access, you will have access to our international internal SharePoint, where you will have all the administrative procedure and information on the current situation in France and at EPITA. It has been designed only for exchange students to help you to do all the administrative procedure while coming at EPITA. How about the student life in at EPITA and in Paris? So that's when you come for next year's semester, you have the student status, the same status as French students. So you will have discount for the museum and movie theater. You will be able to have a lunch, full lunch for €3.30, which is quite cheaper compared to normal price. And also you will have access to free access to our healthcare system without cost. So, and also reduction on cultural activities. Also, this slide is about the budget you need to have in mind while coming at EPITA in Paris, because Paris is a quite expensive city compared to other cities in France and in the world. So the living expenses per month is about, in US dollar, is about $1,000 to $1,050 there is no housing on campus because we are in the city itself, so we have our housing system to help you to find a place to live. So we will offer all shared room or studio or apartment. So also the price of your living expenses will depend on your selection about housing, because if you have a shared room is about less than 500 euro per month compared to a private studio, which is of course higher, 800 euro per month. So that price living expense depends of course of the way you will live at in Paris. Also at EPITA we have different student association in sport, culture, charity in the heart, and also the association EP World with a program EPBuddy that welcome our students at EPITA international students and show the city around and so on. So they're organizing parties, cheese and wine tasting, French movies projections. So when you come at EPITA, feel free to come in one of these associations. So thank you so much for your attention for this presentation. There's maybe a last video if we have time to play. Otherwise, I will send you the link afterwards. But if you need more information, there's the contact details of my colleague Julien Zrangeno, who is in charge of incoming mobility. He's not here because he's busy in another webinar as well. In Czech Republic currently, so we have to share the presentation, and that's why I'm here. And thank you so much. Thanks for this invitation, ITS. Yes.
Okay, maybe you may inform us well about Marin, Miss Lucy, about Marin as ambassador, user ambassador.
Yes. Exactly. Yeah. Marine is currently one of the students who are currently at ETS for a next semester. So if you're interested to meet him, because I don't know, I can't see him login right now in the meeting. It looks like he's not online right now, but yes. This is you're here. Marin?
No, I didn't find Marin.
No, I didn't see Marin as well. So
yes.
He's on site. So if you want to speak in person with our ambassador, he's currently having a semester at ITS. So I will be more than happy to connect you with an EPITA student who's doing his exchange semester at ITS. So you can have a drink together and share. Also, he will share his view of EPITA, and it will also give you more, logistical information. So it could be a good way to have information on our program as well.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Lucy, for informing Marin, and also for other students, if you would like to meet Marin. Marin is currently, and also juga Pak Ketut Edingge, mostly student EPITA, termasuk Marin juga saat ini sedang study di elektrik, fakulti elektrik. Teman-teman juga bisa ke our office, you can call our office. Normally if they're doing online class, Marin also sometimes online in our office, in ITS Global Engagement Office. Thank you so much, Ms. Lucy, and back to you, MC.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, Ms. Lucy. Thank you very much for the insightful presentation, Ms. Lucy Grasset. Okay, for the participants, if you have any questions, hold on. You can ask your questions later in the breakout room session.
Question?
Yes?
Regarding the cooperation with EPITA, we would like to have a cooperation in the program, for example, maybe global degree program to one or more department in our faculty. Our faculty consists of 6 departments, electrical engineering, informatics, information system, information technology, biomedical engineering, computer engineering. So it would be nice to have a collaboration in degree program, we see, maybe we can talk about it afterwards.
Pak Ketut Edi, maybe if you don't mind, can we move Pak di breakout room for 3 of us, and later the student can show, so we cannot the student will keep presentation, Bapak.
Okay, thank you very much.
So I will assign breakout. Monggo Alia, and after this I will assign a breakout first, so Pak Ketut Edi and Miss Lucy can discussion first. Yeah, so our dean can discuss first. Okay, silakan Alia.
All right, thank you very much. Okay, so for the last presentation today, will be brought by Ms. Mia Hernawati from Kumamoto University Japan representatives. So Ms. Mia Hernawati, I will pass the virtual microphone to you.
Thank you so much. Can you hear my voice?
Yes, it's very clear.
All right, good. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and good afternoon, the distinguished professors and lecturers of ITS, presenters from Daffodil University Bangladesh and EPITA France committee, and also participants. I'm so happy to be able to be here and participate on this program. Thank you so much. And it was my second time joining this event, and it was amazing as always. So today we'll have several informations about Kumamoto University, for those who might not know about this before. And also we have some of the information about study in Japan. Maybe you might need these informations. And then I also want to have a kind of a brief take a walk at our Kumamoto University. So before I start the PPT, so how about if we take a walk for a minute to Kumamoto University, Japan? I would like to ask a staff of ITS to help me out with the video. Thank you.
Okay, Mbak Mia, wait a second. Wait a second. Wait a second. It's the video or the introduction, but
The video first also. Okay, thank you.
Okay, the video first. So let me start the video.
Okay. I chose Kumamoto because it is surrounded by beautiful nature.
Kumamoto is a beautiful place, small city, but nice for living.
I like the atmosphere of this place.
A really nice place, and because of Natsume Soseki.
University is very famous for developmental biology and regenerative medicine.
The people in Kumamoto are so friendly and they helping so much.
Why?
I chose Kumamoto because it's like my Japanese hometown. Big enough to always have fun, but small enough to walk everywhere.
Nice people, nice place, nice weather.
Kumamoto Castle.
Kumamoto Castle.
Kumamoto is full of new experiences every day.
Thank you so much for helping me, Mr. Wayu. So we are including in one of the top global universities in Japan. So we have about 30 top global universities in Japan. We have three ranks, and first rank is the most famous university in Japan, like Tokyo University or Todai. And we are in the second rank for the international effort for Kumamoto University to be at least within 10 or 15 years ahead, we are kind of projected to be as a first rank, I hope. So we hope. Thank you so much. So now we are taking our time first and to see about Kumamoto University from the introductions PPT. So this is belongs to Professor Mitsuyo Kishida. So Ms. Professor Kishida is the our professor at Kumamoto University who handled the international affairs. And this PPT was just last January, 13 January, it was presented by her, and I'm taking this opportunity to share with you all. And then that's next. So where we are, so we have we are in southern part of Japan. We are in the Kyushu Islands. So we have Kumamoto city here. So it was around 740,000 populations. And as you see the buildings from first slide, it was in the left side is a library. And then we also have a right side is the national how we call it? A very famous landmark for Kumamoto University, so-called as Fifth High School. And we also have a nature. Kumamoto University have a kind of combinations between a nature and modern life. So we are kind of mixed with each other. And then it's great to live there with a very reasonable price and also good weather, as it says in a video. And we have Mount Aso, we have Amethyst Island, we have Minamata, experience pollution disease. You might heard about Minamata before. So we have this kind of places to have to memorize this kind of the problematic things will happen in the environmental. And then we have next, we have also a history and culture. We have Kumamoto Castle. It is located in the central of the city. We have also Suzenji Garden, and also we have Kumamon. So Kumamon is a popular mascot, yes. But I see, I assume that you can see Kumamon in Indonesia as well. Yeah, a lot of miniature or kind of souvenirs or booty bags with this kind of Kumamon's mascot. Okay, next. Quality living in Kumamoto City. So this one is produced by Kumamoto City. So what is like? So let's see. Next. We have 10,000 students, 500 international students, and there are three ranks. First is China, second is Indonesia, and the third is South Korean. So at the time, we have this Indonesian population students is the second rank, so it's feel like home. So you can have your own family there in a kind of very diversity. And we also have Kumamoto Masjid. So we have a mosque near Kumamoto University. So behind the Kumamoto University Kurokami campus, you can walk at least 5 or 10 minutes. And we have 2,700 faculty and staff members. Next. We have these kind of faculties, and we Kumamoto University have made kind of MOU with ITS, and we have been friends since 2006. It's a long journey, and thank you so much for ITS for having us as your ITS big family, and we would like to be able to support you, ITS students, and also our partners to go to Kumamoto University, Japan. And next. We have several graduate schools at Kumamoto University. Okay, 6 graduate schools. And next. Okay, next, please. International exchange, yes, we have international partners, 281 universities among 53 countries and regions. And also we have 9 offices and 8 countries or regions, including ITS office. So Kumamoto University previously from 2010 up to 2009, yeah, 2009, it's really kind of independent Kumamoto University office, but start from 2010 up to 20, yeah, it becomes our independent office. But now from 2020, we are kind of having our own, how can I say, office belongs to 6 national universities in Japan. So we have several universities collaborated as a 6 source. So it has Nagasaki University, Kanazawa University, Okayama University, we have the Chiba University, we have Niigata University, and also we have Kumamoto University. So as long as you might want to ask any information about those 6 universities, I may can help you, but today let's talk about Kumamoto University. Thank you. Next. So at the university level, we have several universities, as you can see, in Indonesia. So a lot of Indonesia we have. And we have a good mutual understanding with them. We have a good cooperation with them. And I hope we can also have a good future beneficial cooperation in the future. Next. Okay, this is our advanced research magnesium research center, which is very kind of famous in Kumamoto University. And with it was kind of, they produce, we call it Kumada alloy. So it was very thin and very light compared to a magnesium alloy. And it was a kind of made by in lab of Kumamoto University, one of the research center. And it was, it was made and also produced as the body of the aircraft in Japan. So this is the magnesium research center. Next. We have industrial nanomaterials and we have a pulse power science. Okay, next. Sorry, we have a limited time, so I have to skip several times. Okay, so we have also 8 research, which is from Faculty of Medicine. So Kumamoto University have 3 campuses. First is the Kurokami campuses for engineering, science, education, blah, 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 and others. If we have a Onjo campus for Faculty of Medicine, and we also have Kumamoto University Hospital. So in Honjo campus, we have Kumamoto University Hospital, and behind that hospital, we have Faculty of Medicine. And the third is the Oe campus. Oe campus is for only for a pharmacy. Okay, skip next. Yes, we also have this Institute of Molecular and Biology and Genetics. Next. Ese Bungo Research Center is for literature. So we have a lot of 100,000 pieces of almost kind of during the Edo period. And it was very amazing. So we can have this text of the very ancient scrolls. So it was amazing. Okay, next. We have exchange students, short-term exchange and summer programs, and also we have double degree programs for master and doctorals, and also we have English-based degree program. For unfortunately, for Kumamoto University itself, for master and doctoral, we don't have international class for all the graduate schools. So we have the Graduate School of Science and Technology and also Medicine, which provide the international class. So for those of you who have a kind of very really keen to apply for master or doctoral at Kumamoto University beside the Graduate School of Science and Medical, unfortunately, you had to make a kind of effort to have the N2 Japanese English course. Otherwise, we cannot accept international classes beside GSST or medical. Okay, and exchange students, yeah, we have short-term exchange opportunity for the, because of COVID, due to COVID, we cannot have this short-term exchange for this past 2 years, and also summer program also declined, and double degree programs, some of them, we have kind of both online and also offline. So right now, we have those classes. Unfortunately, those who are kind of flight to Japan is lately around last September. That's the last group max scholarship went to Japan. And after that, unfortunately, it was halted because the entry restriction from Japanese government to enter Japan or Kumamoto City is not yet lifted up. So we are kind of waiting for the policy and regulations to be lifted up for Indonesia to come to Kumamoto University, because we have some of the Indonesian students who are still learning online class right now and very, very kind of very happy if they can go to Japan right now. It's unfortunately, but hopefully this 2020, we can have this kind of exchange students again. So we have exchange students for undergraduate and also postgraduate students. We also have, for summer program, we have only for undergraduate. Okay, next. Yeah, this is the short-term exchange program. So we are kind of having this programs package as the international language English. Body, if you cannot speak any Japanese language at all, so you can have this opportunity to join us. So we have also JASO. So it's supported by JASO scholarships. So I hope that we can have more international students, ITS students, to go to Japan with this JASO scholarship. Next. Summer program also we have from JASO, but very limited. But some of the summer program from ITS, it was very good. So we have around 10 or something summer program, those who purchase partial scholarship or full scholarship, or even paid by themselves. It was a great opportunity for those of you who want to visit and experience the atmosphere of Japan. Next. Okay, this is English-based degree programs by GSST. Okay, so mainly Japan have two admission time. First is in April and second is in October. So the highest peak, the highest peak of the international students within October. So this this admission time is yearly. So, okay, next. All right, it is the doctoral of the Graduate School of Medical Science. And so, next. Okay. This is the international students link. All right. So we have this kind of academic advisor or professor from the university. So for those who hope, for those of you who want to ask more about this, where I should get the research supervisor and from the university, just you can call me. You can have me in the email so I can explain you more about that. And also I have the kind of, hopefully I have a session, very short session, but I will inform you about the, some of the way to get the international supervisor for master or doctoral degree. Next. Okay, next. Yes, we have financial. We have Max. Yes, we have Max. So this is important. So Max scholarship is a, we have three kinds of Max scholarship. Max is a, actually Max is the Minister of Education, Sport, Science, Culture and Technology, Science and Technology. So because of too long, so we can make it kind of make an abbreviation of that, so we can call it Max. So the a product or the scholarship is we can call it as a Mungusho or Mamugala Kusho. So we have around 140 or 144,000 per month. For 144,000 yen per month. So and the living average at Kumamoto City is about 80,000 yen. So you can have your family together with you. Okay, so we have Max Embassy of Japan. So we have Max G2G, general to general, to the government to government is general admission. So all of you who don't have the MOU is no problem, as long as you apply at Japan Embassy in Jakarta, and also you have the recommendation letter. And the second is the U2U. Max U2U is university to university. For those of you who want to apply this, just your university and your host university and home university must have the MOU. Okay, so this is the Max U2U. So, and then we have also for IT, for Kumamoto's case, yeah, I don't know for other university, Japan others, but we have a kind of special, we call it special allocations for science, electrical and science engineering. So this max is the same amount, but different kind of categories. And those who can apply these special allocations, this from Malaysia, from Brunei, from Thailand, from Vietnam, and from Indonesia as well. So this is kind of a very good opportunity for the students who works and in the field of computer science and electrical engineering to apply for this program. Next. Yeah, we have international house, we have boarding house, we have tutor systems, yes, and Kumamoto University have international house, Kumamoto University international house, and also boarding house. This is a kind of apartment, yeah, this kind of apartment, and also not belongs to us, but kind of different outside of really, we usually use the international house as our accommodation for international students. We have a single rooms, we have also a family rooms, we also have a share room. Okay. Next. Okay, thank you so much for your attention and go to the second PPT. Yeah, this is very important, but maybe I hope you can have more information about the scholarship or study in Japan. So I take this from the study in Japan groups. So today, universities, supervisor, finance, and contacts. So the contact itself is you can contact me, and then I will also, if you have any information about Payama, Kanazawa, and others, which is related to their own specific things, I can help you to connect with them. Okay, next. This is Japan. Okay, so we have a number of international students studying in Japan. Okay, quick fact about Japan. Next, we have culture, nature, safety, food, and others. It's remarkable days. We have this kind of things in Japan. And next. Okay, so collect and find plan. Yes. So before you start having a plan to go to Japan or abroad, this is actually not only Japan. You can make it for your own necessity. Maybe you want to go to Europe, you want to go to another Asia countries or others, but you can have this kind of things as your basic guidelines. So collect and find plan first, of course. Find out what happens and the requirements and preparations. So I hope that by having this kind of LSA, you can prepare yourself. For instance, for TOEIC or for IELTS and others. So because you have to keep in your mind, if you want to go study abroad, means that at least you can have a good requirement English score. That's the most important thing, even though not in Japan, but at least you have. Yes, okay, TOEFL, IBT, and IELTS, okay? So which school? Okay, collect, fine, plan. And then go to the Japanese N1 or N2, okay? Or you can have the English one, so your language. So, and then after that, yeah, most of international students, of course, English, but if you have time, so you can learn also Japanese language. So the highest one is N1. The highest one is N1, so 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So N1, or for N2, minimum N2, it means that how we should know whether we are N2 or not. Okay, so N2 means that you can write, you can read Japan newspaper. Okay, that's what Japanese friends told me. So if you can read Japanese newspaper, so we can have the N2 or N1 at least. So that's the language. And then the third one is the research plan and academic knowledge. Okay, so in Japan, all of the universities in Japan for master and doctoral means that you are research based. Means that before you go, before you depart, you have to find the prospective professor first. Professor willing to accept you on his or her laboratories when you apply and you get succeeded. So make it a discussion, sharp, efficiently, interview, and then go to into one point. Okay, let's do this. And then apply. And then if you get this kind of permissions, once you get the scholarship, you can go directly to this lab because for master and doctoral is research-based. So you have to find the professor first, of course. So not only Kumamoto University, all universities in Japan. Okay, next, after that, you have a good GPA, good achievement. So right now, if you are the participants have the kind of now, it's first semester or second semester, try your best to get the GPA because in max, you need to have around 2.30 score. 2.30 score, it doesn't mean that in Indonesia, your grade is 2.30, no. Your grade must be 3.5. Okay, it's equal kind of 3.5. And then we have the applications, exam, and interview. So you have to kind of reward yourself with a good efforts from right now, okay, to have a good results later on. Next. Okay, so we have research database. Yes. So for those of you, I don't know, Miss Mia, where do I should find the professors? First one is go to the university's homepage. So in university's homepage right now, most of the universities in Japan, they have put the kind of click on the research database. Why? Because they fully understand that the students will find the professor. Okay, that's the first one. Contact the homepage of the university, or you can have your own kind of, if you have the alumni, you have kind of a lecturer or a supervisor from ITS or from other university, our partners, the alumni is your professor, our alumni, Kumade University, Kumade or Kumamoto University is the alumni, and then he or she is your lecturers, you can have the recommendation from him or her. So the professor or the research, having kind of chit-chat or something and having kind of discussions, which professor might have kind of can accept me or something, blah, blah, blah. Or if you cannot have that one, you can go to research database. This is general, all Japan. Japan's university, you can use this one. So you can find and then click name and then click the research and blah. Okay, all the listed professors are appears. So just find out which field are kind of connected or similar with you. Next. Okay, you can have also research articles database. So you can have the more information about their articles, and you can have the CV, research plan, transcript, and recommendation letter from your home university. So make sure to have, I can share you this slide. So don't worry, I can share you later on. Okay, next. Finance and scholarship, next.
Maybe you may speed up a bit, Ma. Thank
okay,
you.
So sure. This is National University. So National University is for those who funded, fully funded by the government, and local public fully funded by the province, and private university is the subsidiary financed by the government. Next. Okay, this is the average academic fee. Okay, next. Okay, so we also have kind of tuition waiver for kind of several, if you don't have kind of enough money at the time, so you can have this kind of deduction. Next. Okay, we have full and partial scholarship, next. Okay, this is max scholarship, religious scholarship, ADB program. I will show you later on. You can have this time for your visit to the URL and the next. Okay, next. Sorry, I think it's already. Okay, so it's expensive. So this is the average monthly living cost. We are in Kyushu Island. Next. Okay, so Kumamoto University also have career development program. So it's guide you how to work in Japan. So in Japan, we have a
okay, it seems there is electricity in ITS, so it's okay, maybe we can stop share of Mbak Mia. Maybe we can start for the breakout room. Sorry for the dark because it's suddenly electricity. Thank you. Mbak Mia, still here? Not? Okay. Okay, committee, maybe you may help me to announced for the breakout room. For the rest of the Kumamoto, I will call Mbak Mia and also maybe I will help to later. Ya, silakan teman-teman.
Further, find out about
I still cannot hear you, Alia.
Could you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay. So now to further find out about the university that you are interested in, we are about to divide you into three breakout rooms. The first room is for Daffodil International University Bangladesh. The second room is for EPITA France. And the third room is for Kumamoto University, Japan. You can change your display name into university underscore name underscore student number as sent by the committee in the chat box. Okay. Okay, I see some of you already changed your display names. So please, for the operator, you can let the participants into the room of their choice.
Okay, since it's already 16:50, I suppose we can start our discussion. For every participants who can turn on their camera, you may turn on your camera so we can start our discussion. So hello everyone, good evening. First of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Johanna Caroline Sydney Munte and I am a volunteer from ITS Global Engagement. Today, I will be your moderator in this session. To start off our discussion, I'd like to say thank you so much to the Daffodil International University Bangladesh. We are grateful for your willingness to share with ITS students about the Daffodil International University Bangladesh through this program. Let me remind you again that Mr. Shad Royhan and Mr. Nazmul Islami are the representatives for the Daffodil International University Bangladesh. So, in the previous session, everyone has already got insights about the Daffodil International University Bangladesh and also about the opportunities to join their programs. So, for the next 10 minutes, you can ask more detailed questions to Mr. Shad Royhan and Mr. Nazmul Islami, which is related to the Daffodil International University Bangladesh or even any programs that you're interested in joining in. Please don't hesitate to convey anything that you think is still unclear or perhaps you need more explanation related to the previous presentation. You may use the raise hand feature or type your question through the chat box using the format name underscore NRP underscore question, or as you can see as the example sent by our committee in the chat room. And also, if any of you struggle to ask your question in English, you may use Bahasa Indonesia instead. Later on, the committee will help to translate it. However, we do encourage everyone here to try using English as a form of practicing the language. So if you guys plan to register for one of the programs in the Daffodil International University Bangladesh, I do believe that this could be your great opportunity to do a consultation about any related things. Because we can say that not all ITS students are lucky enough to get this kind of opportunity, which is being in the same Zoom room with the representative of the partner university. Okay, so while waiting for the participants to ask questions, maybe I will see some questions that were previously asked by the participant in the registration form. Okay, so we have a question from Muhammad Kashi Ramadan Torori Putro. Okay, so he's not here. And the question is, what is the learning environment at the university like and what makes this university stand out and different from others? Maybe from Mr. Shad Royhan or Mr. Nazmul Islami, are you interested in answering it?
Yeah, so thank you for the question. So the difference is we always prefer the industry academia linkage as well as the alumni environment in the learning process. So when we have the students in different departments, we always encourage the students to connect with the alumni as well as we design our curriculum and deliver everything, focusing on the industry demand. So we invite a lot of industry experts as well as the people, those who are actually successful in their career as well as being an entrepreneur or being an industry expert. So we invite them in the learning process. So apart from other universities, when you will be part of our university, as I mentioned in my presentation, that our university, we have a big family named Daffodil family. There are a lot of companies. So when you study in our university, you will have actually multi different kind of experiences from the industry with alumni, as well as technology and entrepreneurship. So creating entrepreneurship is also another aspect in our university. We are very much friendly in digitalization. In our university, all the full-time students, they receive a laptop when they take the admission in our university. So digital amenities, even during the COVID-19, we also enable different digital features, also learning management system. So there will be no more problem. You will be actually having a sustainable planning for your education if you start your journey with our university. So this is actually, I think, the very important factor of our university.
Okay, amazing answer from Mr. Shatraihan. So it seems that studying in Daffodil International would be very convincing for our future, because it is very family-like in the university. Maybe from Mr. Nasmo Islami, is there any additional information?
Thank you. Sir already said about this opportunity. I think it's all okay for us.
Okay, so I'll go to the next question that was asked in the registration form. There's a question from Vincentius Gusti Putu Agung Bagus Mahendra. What are the benefits of joining this program? Perhaps from Mr. Nasmul Islam, are you interested in answering? What is the benefit of joining the program?
We have not only the joint program, but also we have some exchange program also. Every time we are studying with, last time we also have the exchange program with the ITS also. That's the EPITA and something else. And this exchange program and also the joint term program, there has lots of opportunity with our student to cross-cultural activities, as well as the their new friends and the new communication with the others, and sometimes that new communication with others, and lots of things is available also. I think the Islam sir will also do better in this question. And also, I add something is that in this exchange program, as well as the joint term program, our student as well as our partner universities students also get some credit. That's what we are providing, and our partner university also provide some credit to students. It's a various main benefit to students also. I am going to the Rahim Islam sir for the better.
Yeah, Mr. Najmal, you rightly pointed. Yes, when your students join the programs that our university organized, like summer school or winter school program, that are also focusing on not only the classroom, but also mix up with our local students, local community, go to the community, learn about the techniques like practical oriented learning experiences. And of course, the programs that we host here, like summer school or winter school program, normally the students also receive the academic credits. Like the summer school program, they receive 3 academic credits. Even if it is online, they also receive the same. So they can actually convert this academic credit to their university academic transcript and also get it more internationally validated. So this is what I think is more important.
Okay, such an amazing explanation. So joining the Daffodil International University would not only help us in gaining new relations, but also academically. Okay, since some of the questions from the registration form has been asked, perhaps from the participant in this room Zoom, are there anyone interested in asking questions? Okay, it seems like everyone is still preparing or considering what to ask. Well, I have a couple of questions. So previously in the presentation, there is about the social business competition. I'm interested in knowing more about the competition. So maybe Mr. Shatraihan could explain first about what is the competition about and what are the advantages of joining the competition.
Yeah, do you mean the summer school program or the competition? I didn't get your point.
The one in your presentation, is it
competition or
no, it is actually the summer school program.
Okay,
but inside the summer school program, of course, we have also social business design lab. So what we actually do in the program, like the first the participant, they arrive to the country, they know about the social business, the basic ideas, the knowledge from the experts, and then we prepare them with different teams with multinational participants, like maybe one team with participants from Iran, from Malaysia, from Indonesia, from Bangladesh, from Nigeria, from France, like multinational group. And they start doing the research on different social problems, maybe in local area of Indonesia, Surabaya, or maybe in Bangladesh. And then within the team, they start designing a business model, which can help to develop the society as well as will be sustainable to run the business for many more years. And they design the business, and on the last day of the program, they deliver this business model, the social business design model in front of the experts and academicians. And like there are about seven teams or eight teams, and then one team became the winner. Of course, others will also receive the certificates and recognition, but they will be, of course, the winner, and they will be also receiving different awards. Might be cash prize, might be certificates and other recognition. So this is what we do inside the summer school program, the competition that you have mentioned.
Okay, maybe Mr. Nasmul Islam, is there any additional information?
Yeah, already told our Islam now, but I'm inviting you all to our next International Social Business Summer Program. Hopefully, from your university, university student will come to this program and join me here. It's so much amazing. And also, here also we are give some credit, okay, 3 credit to the student. Okay.
Okay, thank you so much for the answer, Mr. Shad Royhan and Mr. Nasmul Islam.
Maybe I would like to ask Johanna. Yes, you mentioned that your three semester is your semester into three period, right? However, in ITS we are divided into two semester. So I just want to ask, is there any possibility, for example, ITS students can do exchange, yeah, between maybe semester 1, 2, or 3. However, in order to complete their semester, so to be equal with ITS, they can extend, for example, the another option is maybe they will join 2 semester, or they can join, for example, 1 semester in your site and 2 months lab internship, for example. Do you think it's possible for that some flexibility case? Because and for the optional too, how about the MOU that will cover? Because if I'm not mistaken, the MOU is mentioned is about a week, 1 semester. So do if they took option 1, 2 semester exchange, do they need to pay for the second semester? And how about also the lab internship, is it also possible? Because if yes possible, maybe I will try to encouraging our third year student or like semester 7, yeah, in the last semester, so they can do exchange in your terms, and maybe they can join the 2 months in virtual internship as the part of their preparation final project in order to be completed before they come back to ITS. So what do you think, Mr. Shed or Mr. Nasmul? Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. So I have actually 2 options for you. Number one is we have similar experience before. Like we have exchange student from Taiwan who actually came to our university for 1 semester. And she liked the environment, and she stayed actually for 1 year. So we considered this student to study more semester, maybe not only say 4 months, but maybe 2 semesters or even maximum 1 year, depending on our partnership agreement. So we can actually work on it. If you think that your student need to do internship because there are semester different, like in the Department of English, they're coming maybe from your university for 4 months from January to April, but she or he has actually like 2 months left for to start the semester in ITS. So these two months he or she can stay in our university because we have also international school, which is like English medium school, where they can do some intention like teaching or helping the teacher or something like that. And of course these three more high certificate of intention. We also did the same with our partners from other countries also. Apart from that, the second option is for the fall semester, which is almost similar to your calendar, like our yes. fall semester is starting September in
yes.
December. So I think this semester is totally okay so far with the university. So for other semesters, for example, for 6 months, maybe one semester or 2 months of this, or maybe 6 months. Or else we can do it for the fall semester. Both are okay for us.
Okay. Great. So I will send you that email after this then. Yeah, because we are preparing to promoting for the fall one, for the fall September impact. Thank
yeah.
you so much,
yeah,
Richard, for giving me
insight
flexibility. Thank you.
Yeah.
Back to you, Hannah.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Wahyu, for your question, and also Mr. Chef Raihan for the answer. Unfortunately, everyone, the session has come to an end. Thank you so much for your enthusiasm, and perhaps from Mr. Shad Royhan and Mr. Nasmul Islam, is there any closing statement you would like to add?
Yeah, please, closing statement, Mr. Royhan.
Yeah,
Mr. Shad.
So it was really great to take part today in this program, and I believe that the participants who are joining here today, they have learned the academic excellences of three different universities from Bangladesh, from Japan, as well as from France. And I believe they will be also looking for different opportunities that our institutions are offering. And they will be taking part to be more active internationally and be a global citizen. And good luck to everyone. And thank you so much, ITS International Affairs team. I mean, the global linkage team. And I hope that in coming days, we'll have many more new opportunities we'll be sharing with each other. And I'm already connected with many of you. So there will be a lot of opportunities. And if the students have any query, do not hesitate to contact us, even in WhatsApp. Mr. Wahyu has my number. And of course, you can also email us. And my colleague, Mr. Najmul, and me, we are always here for you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Shen. Mr. Najmul, thank you.
Thank you so much. Our ongoing program, we have an ongoing program, the Maxwell Postgraduate Research Summit 2022. I already given the link in chat. You can register there. Thank you so much, Rajesh.
Yes, yes.
We can hopefully get some participants from you.
Yeah, we already spread to our social media, and also we are ready forward to my college, Ms. Nabila, who handling for the postgraduate workshop. So they inform to our WhatsApp group to all postgraduate students in ITS. So hopefully, yeah, I will keep contact to Mr. Chef Rehan to asking if there are any ITS participants. Thank you so much. So Johanna, maybe we can back to the main room for the closing.
Okay, so thank you once again to Mr. Shah Royhan and Mr. Nasmul Islam. And that is all from me as the moderator. I am truly sorry if there are any mistakes that I made during the session. And now, everyone, you may return to the main room to continue to our next session. Thank you, everyone.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so maybe we can just start our discussion right now. So, hello everyone, good afternoon. First of all, I would like to introduce myself. So my name is Samuel Nehemi Agung. You can call me Samuel, and I'm a volunteer of ITS Global Engagement and will be your moderator in this breakout room session. First of all, I would like to thank would like to say thank you very much to Ms. Lucy that already joined and attend this session. We are really grateful to you for willing to share with ITS students about EPITA School of Engineering and Computer Science France through this program. And I would like to remind all of the participants that Ms. Lucy is one of the representatives of EPITA School of Engineering and Computer Science France. And in this and in the previous session, we already got some insights about EPITA France and other opportunities to join programs with EPITA France. So for the next maybe 10 until 20 minutes, you can ask more detailed questions or anything to Miss Lucy related to EPITA School France and other programs that provided by EPITA. So please do not hesitate to convey anything you think is still unclear, or perhaps you need more explanations related to the previous presentation. You can just use the raise hand feature or type your questions through in the chat box Zoom with the format your name underscore student ID number underscore your question. And if you guys plan to register for one of the programs in EPITA France, I think this could be the great opportunity to do a consultation about any related things, because we can say that not all of the ITS students get these opportunities and this kind of advantage, which is in the same Zoom room with the Miss Lucy right now. Okay, maybe to all of the participants can raise the, your hand to ask directly to Miss Lucy.
Yes, don't be shy. And I understand that the presentation was quick. So before you have any question, I would like to share with you a link that was in my presentation, but I can post it on the discussion. Is a dedicated SWAY, which is an online presentation in which you can have updated information about the exchange program. So before I can show you how it looks like, and you can stop me anytime you have a question. Okay. So I don't know if you see my screen now.
Yeah.
Yes,
we can already see our screen. But excuse me, Miss Lucy. One of the participants already raised their hand.
Great. Oh, thank you.
I think I see Koshi Ramadan. Maybe you can unmute your microphone and ask directly your questions to Miss Lucy.
Okay. Thank you, Sam. Thank you for the opportunity. And hi, Miss Lucy.
Thank you. Hi, okay. Koshi.
Yes, my name is Koshi. I want to ask you some questions related about EPITA. First, is there any major related to business statistics? Because currently I am studying in business statistics and I would love to, you know, learn more, especially in EPITA, because you mentioned about EPITA basically institution and most of the major related to engineer and this kind of thing, such as technology. So yeah, first I would love to know about, is there any major that related to business statistics? And the second one, how about the learning system and the learning environment and in EPITA that perhaps different than others? Is that clear?
Yes, that is clear, and this is a very good question, actually.
Thank you.
So your first question about statistics and analytics. I share with you my screen again to show you how to find the program that will be the closer one to what you have currently in ITS. So on this way, so the link I share with you on the discussion, you go down and you have here all the list of program we have in English for students, for exchange students to come. Okay. So I think maybe the one that is more focused on statistics and analytics will be because maybe it's not exactly the same, data science and analytics. Or I don't know, informatics, that could be this one, but when you click on it, you will have a deeper understanding of the program in itself and see how it's look like. So, and that will also answer to your second question about how we teach computer science in at EPITA, because EPITA is not a university. we are a private engineering school, so it's completely different. When students come at EPITA, they have to get the whole program. They cannot select, you know, as you may done in your at university, select classes and do their one program. They have to follow the same track to get a degree. So when they come for this specific program, data science and analytics, that could be maybe similar to the statistics and so on, but with a strong focus on programming as well. You have the course list here, the teaching units, and also below you will have a syllabi. So you will see what the classes is focused on, okay? And if you need more also details on each class, for instance, you do not see the syllabi for data science in production, you just send me a mail to me and I will send you the course description. Regarding the way we teach computer science at EPITA, the students have a full program. It's a lot of teaching hours. We like having a student at EPITA working with our teacher in small groups. So we don't have big, there are small group of 20 students in a class and they are having teaching hours or labs and they need to work in project in most of the classes. So working group and work on projects. We also organize a lot of challenges in like hackathon for students. So in every week will be different. I can show you how the schedule of data science and analytics currently on our platform. So you will see that it's actually really different to every week will be different. And so when you go EPITA, let's see, Master of Science and Artificial Intelligence System. Let's see the class. So this is the current week. So we start classes on Monday and it's ending in Friday. And as you can see, the schedule is quite intense. And so now they are working on autonomous car. This is artificial intelligence system. Sorry, my apology. You would like to have more information on, let's say, data science and analytics. So here the week for the students who are learning data science and analytics. So they have mathematics, they have French class also, because when you come at EPITA, you can also have French classes integrating your program every Tuesday and Thursday afternoons. And then all weeks will be different. So, and we schedule classes from time to time. So sometimes you have some day off, but this is a typical week. So every week will be different. Our teacher also is a researcher that we have at EPITA because we have different labs, or they are actually working in companies. So they have a professional background and they also update the courses according to the new technology as well. Do you have any other question? Or is it replying to your question, Koshi?
Yeah. Can you write down about your email? Because I really want to know about the syllabus, the description of the syllabus there, because yeah, if I want to do exchange program, I will write about this kind of thing. So yeah, and of course, thank you so much for your elaboration. It's really illuminating, and yeah, I'm so glad to meet you here now. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Hope to see you soon.
Okay, thank you very much for Koshi and also Miss Lucy for the answer. Okay, so let's moving on. Is there any participant who like to ask about EPITA France or anything regarding to learn in France or about lifestyle in France, culture in France, or anything? We really encourage you to ask directly to Miss Lucy about this, because as I mentioned before, not all of the ITI students get this kind of advantage. So it will be great if you ask the question directly to Ms. Lucy.
Okay, feel free to ask your question whenever you want. I would like to share also with you Campus France website. That could be a quite useful website to get all the information about France and how to come in France and the French lifestyle as well. So I share with you this link. So you can click here to select your country, because every country has its own, I will go back and select English and then, let's see, I'm not in the correct campus, but you can stop me anytime, okay?
Okay.
This one, it's in Thai. You can select, it's only in English, sorry. And now you can select this language as well. So I share with you this. That could be also a way to have information about studying in France.
Okay, thank you very much. Actually, I have another question to Ms. Lucy. Since I'm still in ITS, there is a human, a social science major, and I'm from one of the social major in ITS. I would like to ask, is there any social science major or department in EPITA, or is it already all of the major is engineer or science major?
Yes, you're right. EPITA, we are focused on engineering and mainly in computer science. So it's not all engineering major, it's only specified on computer science. So when you go on our website, I share with you the link, also you can have a look to all the program we offer. you will have less major in English, but I don't know how many credits you need to. If you come for an exchange program, some university does not require you to take the all of the courses. So maybe if you're interested in just learning French, we have, for instance, a program to learn French for a semester. So we call it French by EPITA. So you click on here and you can come at EPITA and learn only French and French culture, okay? So that could be a possibility if you're interested in humanities and languages. We have a full program in English, in French, from A1, so from beginner level to C1, and you can have 15 teaching hours per week and 10 hours of personal work, and the rest you can travel and visit Paris and France. That could be a good opportunity if you want to have, yes, to get a good knowledge in French. And our teachers, they are all, really enjoyable. We have small groups of also when you learn a language, it's only 10 to 15 students maximum. So very, very small groups. And you will know how to write, read, speak, and understand French,
okay,
within 14 weeks. So that could be an option. Otherwise, yes, it's focused on engineering, computer science. Sorry.
Okay, so it is still possible for us as a social students to learn French in EPITA, right?
Yes. And it will be, and if you're a group, we can also design, if you come, at 10 students, we can create a world program for you and have both, French class, but also management class as well, something like that. We can design something.
Okay.
Your group of students, okay?
Okay, that will be great. Okay, thank you very much for Miss Lucy. Okay, for
thank
all
you.
Of the participants, unfortunately, it's has been around 15 minutes since we start our discussion. So the session has ended. Thank you very much for all of the enthusiasm. And also thank you very much for Miss Lucia, for Miss Lucy, for the time and enlighten us with the answers. Maybe from Miss Lucy, do you have something to add for the closing statement?
Yes, thank you so much for joining us for this session. It's quite short, but you are welcome to join us for any information session we organize every month. So I will be sending you the leaflet. If you want to subscribe to this, I will also share the, so you can come and just also contact me if you need more information. The last link I shared with you was on the video on the orientation week we organize for international students that come at EPITA. So you can watch it on yourself and have a look to how the campus is, how is a welcome week, okay? And feel free to contact me anytime. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Okay, thank you very much, Ms. Lucy. And for all of dear participants, that is all from me as the moderator in the session. I apologize for any mistake that I have made during the session. And we hope that all of your curiosity has been answered. Please return to the main room and we will continue to the next agenda. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Merci.
Maybe you may start, please. Thank you. Mbak Mia already here.
Okay, hello everyone. Good afternoon. Sorry before because in our office, the electricity is down. Okay, first, let me introduce myself. My name is Laura. I'm a volunteer of ITS Global Engagement. And I will be your moderator in this session. Ahead of time, I'd like to say thank you so much to Ms. Mia Hernawati. We are grateful to you for willing to share with ITS students about Kumamoto University Japan through this program. In the previous session, everyone in this room must have already got insights about Kumamoto University Japan and opportunities to join this program with Kumamoto University. So for the next 10 minutes, you can ask more detailed questions to Ms. Mia related to Kumamoto University Japan or any programs you can join. Please do not hesitate to convey anything you think is still unclear or perhaps you need more explanation related to the previous presentation. You can just use the recent feature or type your question through the chat box using format name underscore student ID number underscore question, or as you can see the example sent by our committee in the chat room. If it is hard to speak in English, you may ask in Bahasa Indonesia instead of English, and our committee will translate to English. However, we do encourage everyone here to try using English as a form of practicing the language. If you guys plan to register for one of the programs in Kumamoto University Japan, I think this could be your great opportunity to do a consultation about any related things, because we can say that not all ITS students get this kind of advantage, which is in the same Zoom room with the representatives of the partner university. Maybe is there anyone of you want to ask any questions to Ms. Mia related to Kumamoto University? You may raise hand. Okay, I see there is Narendra. Okay.
Yeah, Pak Narendra, silakan, Bapak.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity. I just want to ask one question. Is there any summer program that conducted by this Kumamoto University by online session?
Okay. All right. May I answer this directly, Laura?
Yeah, Mbak.
Okay, thank you. So thank you so much, Mr. Narendra, for your questions. So unfortunately, we don't have this kind of summer program made by online up to now. So this, our kind of committee kind of having this kind of postponed program for almost 2 years already. So yeah, it's unlikely But anyway, this is kind of things that we try to find the solutions. We never have this kind of online program before. But anyway, unfortunately, not yet. Thank you, okay, Mr. So,
okay. Thank you very much for the question, for the answer. So,
yes, sir.
Kumamoto University only conduct offline.
Kind of. Yes. Actually, yes. Only conduct offline sessions, but for the IJAP, general admissions, yeah, and also for master degree or doctoral degree, we have both online or offline class. But offline is only for very few. But for exchange program, totally we are postponed all the exchange programs up to now.
Oh,
for
okay,
almost 2 years, yes. But hopefully 2020, we have more hopes that it will have kind of having a better situations so that we can have even online or offline.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so
much,
Mr. Narendra. You're welcome, Mr. Narendra.
All right. Thank you, Ms. Mia, for the insightful explanation. And for Mr. Narendra, I hope that we'll answer your question. Okay, moving on to the next question. Maybe there are others who want to ask again. You may raise hand or ask in the chat box. Is there anyone who still has a curiosity? You may ask directly because this is a grateful opportunity to ask to Ms. Mia in here as the representative from Kumamoto University, Japan.
Okay, sorry, Laura. This is the participant is varies from undergraduate, postgraduate, even lecturers, right? For this program.
Yeah.
All right. So For even though we are kind of postponing our programs, but I would like you to know that there are several things that you need to prepare, to be prepared for the exchange program at the Kumamoto University or other universities in Japan. Usually the exchange programs, we have this kind of scholarship from JASO, Japan Student Service Organizations. So this JASO provides 80,000 yen for living. During the exchange program, excluding airfare tickets, the visa, and so it's excluding. So this 80,000 yen is very kind of enough for having 1 month living. And even some of the students, alumni from Kumamoto University informed me that they can save 20 or 30,000 per month from these scholarships. But things that needs to be prepared for having this JASO scholarship is not so easy, but not so difficult as well, if you have a good preparations in advance. So first of all, what you need to prepare, be prepared is the first English, okay? So you still have time, okay? You still have time for preparing this English. There are two kinds, there are two things that you need to prepare in a very good advance. First is GPA. Yeah, GPA, it's not easy as well. So because you have 6 months to have a good GPA every semester. So 2.30 means you need to have around 3.5 or 3.4 or 3.50. That's the requirements, okay, by JASO. And second is the English. We are still receiving the ITP. We are still receiving the ITP TOEFL test. But recently, it was changed. Okay, it was totally changed. We received the IELTS, either TOEIC or IBT TOEFL. So it's not so easy because the how to get the IELTS and how to get the IBT is not so cheap, okay?
So IBT and IOPS can have almost 2.5 or 3 million per test. So you need time to prepare yourself before getting into the test. And TOEIC, maybe I think TOEIC is the more reasonable price. How, after all, not because of the price as well, but the preparations you might need to have to make yourself repaid by these good results. So as you know that IELTS, we need to have around 5.5 up to 6. IBT, we need to have 61. TOEIC, we need to have around 700 score. Okay, so it's kind of competitive and it's almost common for all the programs, even though not Kumamoto University, but other university. Why? Because the scholarships are given by the JASO. Most of them are given by JASO. So the requirement are almost kind of similar. So I think that is the one that I need to kind of emphasize. Okay, so if you have any information, any questions, please kindly let me know so we can have discussions.
Like everyone in this room, you may ask your answer if you have still have curiosity or anything that you think still is unclear, or perhaps you need more explanation again related to the previous presentation. You may ask with raise your hand or ask in the Zoom chat box. That is may is there anything else? Because
I think everyone is clear enough, or or anyone, these two questions, yeah, clear enough or not understand what I mean. Okay. Sorry. So please share our, how can I say, ask anything related to Kumamoto University, or maybe study in Japan. I will try my best to help you.
Maybe, may I ask something? I want, there's something that I curious about.
Yes, please, Laura.
We as international student in Kumamoto University, I just curious that is there an Indonesian student association? Maybe if we study there.
Correct. Okay, so just thank you for that good question. So as you know, that Indonesian student is the second rank of the populations of international students in Kumamoto University. So of course we have the kind of organizations. We call it PPIJ, yeah? So PPIJ, Kumamoto, PPIJ, Tokyo, PPIJ, something, right? It's different city. So PPIJ, Kumamoto is kind of having this kind of organizations. And now it was led by the ITS students who having this kind of doctoral course at Kumamoto University right now. So yes, we have PPIJ Kumamoto, and we have several events. We have several events for international students, for Indonesia especially, and also we have Muslim organizations. Since we have the Kumamoto Masjid, we also have a halal food, Indonesian who have a kind of shops. We call it Mr. Marlo. He owns a shop, halal food. And it was not so far away from Kumamoto University, actually. So it's a kind of, especially the masjid itself, it's only 5 or 10 minutes. So it's kind of convenient, it's actually, for Indonesian students to have to prepare, to have their own kind of halal food. Of course, not so many, but nowadays Japan is growingly kind of having this kind of a consideration to have a more halal restaurant or halal food sold at a convenience store, or we call it konbini in Japan. And also we also have this kind of events for Muslims. So it's like, it's fun. It's a, yeah, it feels like home though you're in Japan, but it feels like home.
Thank you so much for the explanation. It's really insightful.
You want to go to Kumamoto University?
Well, maybe.
I hope. Or maybe other university abroad. So I hope that Laura and all the people here can have the time or can have the opportunity to go wherever you want abroad.
Okay.
I mean, okay.
Sure.
Any other questions, please? Do we still have time, Laura?
No, actually, this is... Yeah, unfortunately, okay. The time for the session has ended.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, guys. Thank you so much for all the enthusiasm. And also, thank you so much for Ms. Mia for the time and enlightened
us.
And maybe from Ms. Mia, do you have something to add for the closing statement?
If you have dreams, if you have plans, act now. Thank you.
All right. Thank you,
Miss Mia. Yes, welcome.
And
thank you so much, Laura.
Okay, thank you so much, Mia. And dear participants, that is all from me as the moderator in the session. I apologize for any mistake that I made during the session, and we hope that all your curiosity has been answered to this program. And for participants, you may return to the main room to continue to the next agenda. Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you so much. Have a great day.
Bye. All right. Welcome back, everyone. I hope that you gain more insights in the breakout rooms. And now we have finished all of our agenda today. I also want to thank all of the participants for your participation and enthusiasm. But before we close our meeting today, I would like to greatly appreciate our representatives from its partner university today. There are lots of changes on offer, which encourages us to work much harder to attain internationalization and worldwide standards. Therefore, we have already prepared very special gifts for our partners. For the operator, you may share the screen, please. And we hope this gift can express our gratitude towards you. Okay, so the first gift is for Daffodil International University Bangladesh. So maybe we can take a picture first, Mr. Shed and also Mr. Ailu. Okay, Nasmul. Okay, I will count it down in 3, 2, 1. All right, thank you very much, sir. Okay, let's move on to the second certificate. The second certificate is for the EPITA France. Okay, hello, Miss Lucy. Thank you very much. I will take a picture. I will calm down. Please give your best smile. In 3, 2, 1. All right, thank you very much. Okay, so for the last certificate is for the Kumamoto University Japan. Okay, I will count down. Please give your best smile, Miss Mia. In 3, 2, 1. All right, thank you very much. Okay, so I have no words other than a big thank you for all of the speakers. I hope that our meeting today can give more insights to all the participants. But before we close our meeting today, let's have a photo session. So for the participants, if you do not have any technical or internet issues, please turn on your camera and show us your best smile. All right, I see some of you has already turned on your camera. And please keep your smile for a moment because we don't know which slide you are on. For the operator, you may take the lead.
Okay, since everyone is ready, I will take the picture for the first slide. 1, 2, 3, smile. Okay, for the second slide, 1, 2, 3, smile. Okay, thank you. Back to you, Alia.
Thank you very much for Marcelli to take our picture today. And now we have finished all of the agenda. And here I also want to thank to all the participants for joining our session today. And also don't forget to fill out the feedback form that is shared by our committee in the chat box so we can improve our future events. We would greatly appreciate if you gave us honest feedback. I will remind you again that filling out the attendance and feedback form are requirements to get stamp for it. And each link will be closed 30 minutes after being shared. Finally, thank you very much, Bapak Ibu from the departments, also for the speakers and for everyone for joining our session today. It was a really enlightening session that provided all of us with new perspectives and encouragement. And I hope to see all of you at our next event. We hope that as a result of this, you will be much more inspired to take part in internationalization activities. I'm Alia as your Master of Ceremony, representing all committees on duty today. I would like to apologize for any inconvenience that happened during the session. Once again, thank you very much for your participation and see you at another event. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.